dumb Sarah. How long has he been in there?
I don't know. Long enough.
Let's go.
Jacob takes long showers. Here at the house, if you take a shower and somebody else runs the water, it causes cold water to come out on the person in the shower. We just wanted to have a little fun with Jacob.
So because our house was built by idiots, if you're taking a shower and somebody turns on the faucet, flushes the toilet, turns on the washing machine, the water straight from the Arctic pumps straight through the shower head, and you just have to sit there and freeze to death. There's nothing you can do.
Do you think that's funny?
What?
This is my life. This is my time. Show me the light, and I don't care.
Why did we take a picture of a bridge?
So, in order to do a project for school, I had to pull up a bunch of pictures, you know, just, you know, boring stuff.
Is that important?
No, I wish we could fix this.
Is that an important bridge?
I don't know what that is. We took a picture of a floating flower.
Well, at least that's artistic. This is literally a picture of a bridge.
I took a picture of the Washington Monument. Is that the Washington Monument?
No, that's the Capitol building.
Huh. Took a picture of the Capitol building.
Civics lesson fail.
Yeah. Took a picture of the Capitol building, but I guess I also took a picture of a turkey?
Was nice. Reminiscing. I think I like myself better with lighter hair. And I really don't mind John being without hair. Actually, as I looked through some of the pictures and seeing how all of his hair starts disappearing, it's kind of weird.
When you had hair.
Who's that? Carolyn.
I'm trying to imagine what you look like with hair. Just, okay.
It was wonderful to have hair. I remember, like, I would go and get it cut, and the girl that used to cut my hair would say, "Gosh, you have really thick hair." Do you know how long it's been since I've heard that?
I know John doesn't like the idea that he's losing hair, but he's not thought about the advantages to it. You know, he was talking about going to Great Clips and getting his hair cut, but we don't even have to wait now because he can go to the express lane where 10 hairs or less and you're in and out.
My dad had hair and it looks a lot like mine, some of them especially. So I'm sort of worried for my future because this is one of the only good things about me, besides everything else. Sons should not have to see their dad doing that to themselves. I'm good.
Mom, I need to tell you something.
What?
Really,
I hope this isn't about another dumb girl.
No, it's not about a dumb girl. Now listen, this is really important. I just walked in on Dad doing something really weird in the bathroom to himself.
What?
This is a safe environment. We want to what's with the wig? Why the wig?
I was trying to get back in touch with my inner hairdom.
Your inner hairdom. What is that inner hairdom?
Many moons ago, I had hair of my own. And
whose hair do you have now?
I don't know. I found it in the basement.
I read on Pinterest that you can put apple cider vinegar on your head every day and it'll cause your hair to grow back out.
Is that like your solution for everything? Apple cider vinegar?
It is. Of course, it did not work very well.
It's like the cure for cancer, the cure for everything else. Just apple cider vinegar. You either drink it, bathe in it.
It's supposed to kill the fleas, but...
It killed the
dog.
I
think you just gave the fleas
the
up
dog
to the
was
drink.
Sick for days from licking all of the apple cider vinegar off him. Apple cider vinegar heals. Ah, I'm working on that right now with my toe. I have a really fungus looking toe and I've been using apple cider vinegar on it every day, watching all that gooey grunk stuff get really nasty. Actually, it's getting nastier. I don't know, my toes been bothering me a lot, so.
Does wearing this wig, does that help the inner you come out?
No, actually, you can't tell a difference when you're in the wig from without it, other than it's hot and itchy. But I'm willing to suffer somewhat in order to replace the missing follicles.
Okay, well, we're just gonna go ahead and take this off, and we're gonna get some real solutions.
Trust me, it works. You'll have hair in no time.
I smell like a pickle. Ah, that's cold. Bridget has this idea with apple cider vinegar like it's God's gift to mankind as the cure for everything. If you have an ache or a pain, you just drink it, bathe in it, wash it on, use it as like a, a rinse or whatever, and it's just going to fix everything. So she's got this crazy idea that apple cider vinegar is going to do something to regenerate hair growth. I think she's crazy.
All righty. Now this comes from a very, very prestigious website called Natural Living. So it may seem a little crazy what I'm doing, but I guarantee it will work just fine. So just gonna start right here with this. That's fine. We'll
get that really, really cold.
Don't worry. Just kind of massage that in there. It's working real nice. Get a nice solid base. Do you feel it? Do you feel that? Yeah, I think I feel the hair growing right now. I think that's what's happening. You smell that? That smells really nice. Okay, now just for a little bit of some nice tomato paste, we're just gonna work that in here. It will really help with opening up the pores and getting that nice in there. It's gonna, yeah. You want some of your eyebrows to grow back? There we go. We'll just put them right in there. Yeah, right in there. Okay, that's nice. Do you smell that? Smells great. Okay, now, in order for it to work perfectly, we do need something to sort of protect the other parts of your scalp. So what we're gonna do here is we're just gonna add a nice layer of protection over top of it, okay? That's what we're doing right here. You see? Yeah, see how that's protecting you right there? Oh, that would be nice. That's gonna work very, very nice. You see how it's protecting you, and your hair can grow.
I think you're making fried chicken.
No, this is not fried chicken. Basically, all we have to do now is come over here, and we turn on the oven here. I'm just gonna bake you.
The oven?
Oh no, it's perfectly safe. Don't worry. I'm just gonna. I need you to sort of like hunch over.
I'm not putting my head in the oven.
No, you're not putting it in the oven. It's okay. Just trust me. Do you trust me? Yes.
No.
Okay, just turn this way. Okay, go ahead and tilt your head down into the oven. Just down. Here, I'll turn on the light so you don't feel as scared. Yeah, that's nice. Okay. All right. You just need it a little bit closer.
Jacob, I'm not getting in the oven.
No, it's fine. It's not. It's on a low temperature. You can just come just a little bit close to the oven, okay? So it's okay. There it is. Now you just stay right there. And it'll...
Well, I understand that there's a thing called holistic, but holistic and whole foods are two different things.
Okay, I know this isn't a hair thing. This is actually a chicken recipe. I saw it on Abbott and Costello, and I wanted to see if he'd fall for it. So let's see how far we can go. Okay, so yeah, look how solid that is. That's a nice solid base there. So what we need to do, in 1 second here. Oh, it's really coming over here. Okay, got it. It's all good. Now we can come right over here. Yeah.
That oven element is getting red.
Yeah, that's what they did. We don't want anything growing right there, do we? No, we don't. Oh, yeah. See how nice it, what are you owing?
The little creases are like digging into my skull.
It helps. It helps with the growing. That's what it's made for, is to help produce growing. Do you see what we were trying to do?
Bake my head in the oven?
Yeah, well, that was a metaphor for the crazy lengths that people go to for vanity. We like you just the way you are. We do. Say that to you.
I love you just the way you are.
Put foil on my head, eggs and flour.
I didn't know he was putting you in the oven.
I did.
But he's the man with the plan.
I'm the man with the plan. Right there.
4 score. And however many years ago, I was brought forth on this continent, a human being with hair. And through the course of time, my hair has departed. One by one, the follicles chose to exit what seems to be permanently my scalp. And as they've exited, I have felt in my heart secure with the fact that I am proud to be bald. God created only a few perfect heads. The rest of them have hair.
Dad's in the shower. Time for revenge.
Relax, Jacob.